the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration. Good morning. Welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. I'm coming to you from Woodbridge. I'm coming to you from second base in Woodbridge. Remember 2 weeks ago, we visited the Tyndall Recreation Center. We talked about public-private partnerships being used to open up shuttered Detroit recreation centers. The young lady walked us through the place. It was amazing. She talked about how there were holes in the ceiling, how it couldn't be used, how nobody wanted to touch it, how the neighborhood was just parched for recreational activity, and life was brought to Tyndall. Well, all throughout that interview, she kept referencing a guy, all right? She kept referencing my good friend, Jimmie Settles. I brought him to you this week from Woodbridge. Mr. Settles.
Hey, Dusty.
Man, I'm not into baseball, but tangy. This is amazing. I'm standing on second base on a new field with freshly laid sod at Woodbridge. Not over in Midtown, I'm in Woodbridge. I'm in the shadow of low-income housing, in the shadow of a school, and here we have this beautiful ball field. This is amazing. Is this part of the dedication of the UAW to the community? What is it?
Yes, UAW 4. This is actually our second field. Mm-hmm. This was named after Mr. Ford, William Ford, who is deceased now. Even though it's called, it's normally formerly Woodbridge, is the Bill Ford Field.
Okay. So, 2 weeks ago, we were over at the Tyndall Recreation Center. Mm-hmm. How the hell did you all decide to step in and do that? That place was amazing.
You know what? It's only by God. Actually, when I first went over there to look at it, I said, man, this is impossible. This place just needed to be tore down and rebuilt. We actually had a contractor to look at it and said it wasn't worth rebuilding. Mm-hmm. But the young lady who runs Tyndall now just never gave up. And she called me back another few months. And her and her volunteers had just did an extraordinary job doing what they can do to bring it back. And I said, you know what? Anybody that has that much moxie and that bravery, we just need the help. And we just, bit by bit, I mean, build it up almost to where it was many, many years ago.
I think it's better. That gymnasium is definitely better. Now, I've toured Detroit College Prep at Northwestern. Mm-hmm. I've seen the new pool. I've seen the new gymnasium. I've seen all this. Why DCP at Northwestern?
Well, you know, we've done many things throughout the city at different schools. It's really ironic. I'm an alum of Northwestern High
really?
School.
Really?
Yeah, not the same school, though. I mean, it's many, many years ago. And the principal, I ran into him at a community event. Mm-hmm. And he told me, said, you know, Jimmie, why don't you come back and do something for your own school? And he gave me, said, you know what? I need my swimming pool rebuilt. And if I get that, I bet you I can double the enrollment. If I don't, the school stands a good chance of closing. So we went over there, and really, I just fell in love with everything, with the school, but and the students in particular. And when you went over there, you see how much they need. We not only, as you know, did the swimming pool, mm-hmm. we did the gymnasium, did the weight room, the locker room, mm-hmm. put new lights, painting over there. And, you mm-hmm. know, it's really a good, great feeling when you go back. Mm-hmm. And actually see the morale of the kids and the teachers mm-hmm. actually change when they're, because their environment has really changed. Mm-hmm.
So. It's amazing. A lot of physical planning renovations when we talk about Tyndall, when we talk about DCP. When we come back for our next segment, I'm going to want you to talk about the non-physical. We'll get to this beautiful field, but you've also done some intellectual things through UAW Ford. I want to talk about those things when we come back. Then we'll talk about this. Just seeing those kids play in what was a shuttered field.
Yeah.
It's beautiful, man.
That's
beautiful.
Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back from Woodbridge with Jimmie Settles from the Ford Athletic Facility. William Clayford.
That's correct.
Athletic Facility. We'll be right back.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market, with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
We are a part of a public-private partnership to place more than 40 kiosks throughout Wayne County to allow you to pay your essential bills and delinquent taxes in one safe, convenient location.
DTE Energy introduced this kiosk program to allow Metro Detroiters greater freedom to pay your energy and other bills when and how you desire, by cash, personal check, or credit card.
At the Detroit Water Department, we are pleased to join our friends so you can now pay your water bill on the DivDat kiosk network.
The kiosks are located in our respective downtown offices, as well as Rite Aid stores and community centers across the county.
As the president of the DivDat Kiosk Network, our mission is to stamp out convenience fees and help you.
Make sure to take advantage of the no-fee kiosks to stay current on your tax, energy, and water bills. Stop by today to learn more about how to enter into a payment plan in the newly extended interest rate reduction program.
Please visit us at DTE Energy,
the Wayne County Treasurer's Office,
or DWSD. We're here to help.
Groundbreaking. Life-saving. History-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from historic Woodbridge, from the William Clay Ford Athletic Facility. My guest is Jimmie Settles, UAW Ford Vice President. Mr. Settles, we talked about a couple of the physical plant things, but you've also done some heartfelt things beyond this. Tell me about this homeless center you redid.
St. Peter, St. Paul, located in downtown Detroit. They were on the verge of closing because they did not have up to specs, but they have been serving the homeless community for many, many years. So we were contacted by the parish and went over there and looked at it, and because of the service that they do for the homeless, we knew we had to help. So we put a significant amount of money into it, and got it up to speed. For the first year, then came back 2 years later and did a nutrition program, to make certain that the homeless can eat properly. Mm-hmm. And we have some social services in there also, so we helped them with that.
Really? Mm-hmm. Now, you do something like that, how does it get sustained? Does UAW Ford sustain it, or is once you build it, are they supposed to stand on their own?
No, they stand on their own, with the exception of these fields. We make certain that we sustain it, we build it into the budget every year to make certain it maintains its current state and beauty. Mm-hmm. This is the second one. We have another in Baldock, which is the oldest.
I love Baldock.
Yeah.
It's right by Bike Tech.
Yes.
Over there on West Warren.
Yeah, that's right. Where you got your big tire bike.
That's where I got my big bike from.
Yeah. And so we make sure we put that part of our budget. And one of the commitments that we've made to the community is that we would not just only build it, that we would maintain it as long as this institution is survival.
Mm-hmm. So what other intellectual things have you done besides Pope Francis?
Oh, man, I tell you, we do a lot. And thank God I have a great staff. We work together. We do Saturdays. We have three schools. So we do Saturday schools that go from 8 to 1. We call it a Saturday at the D. In each school, we have over 400 participants. We run it almost year-round. We have 2 months off during the calendar year. And then we run it every Saturday. We have a cadre of curriculum, some academic and some recreational, both at Northwestern High School and Mufford High School.
All right, so Saturday schools, Saturday in the D.
Saturday in the D, that's what we call it.
That's impressive stuff. That's impressive stuff.
And if we had an hour, I could tell you everything else we do, but I know we don't have that much time. So.
Well, you never know. I can make things happen like that.
Well, why don't we do another show then?
We will. Okay. You know, while we're here, we talk about the rebirth of Woodbridge. DPS and the city of Detroit, they shuttered rec centers. We talked about Tyndall. We talked about that. I look at these little kids out here playing. How important is sports to the development of a city? We talk about education, we talk about jobs, we talk about getting rid of crime, but we don't talk about youth sports.
Yeah, you know, that's one of the things that, you know, we decided to be proactive and not just be a critic. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody complains about kids and how they may or may not act. I don't think all of it's accurate. But, you know, we don't provide a mechanism or a opportunity for facilities that they can come and be a kid. I mean, it's unfortunate in City Detroit. Now, you mentioned about the recreation centers, you can count them on your hand. That are open, but you know, when we came up, we had it. I didn't have a field like this, but we had a decent place to play ball. We have places to go for not only recreation, for music, you just name it. We had that opportunity, and our kids today, unfortunately, don't have the same opportunity that we had.
Okay. When we come back, I want to talk about this facility specifically. And everything that it actually has. I see at least 2 ball fields, but there's more to it than just that. All right? Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in a few minutes with Jimmie Settles, Vice President, UAW Ford, and it's all about this William Clay Ford Center.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Now, see more homes for sale than ever at buildingdetroit.org, including Own It Now homes, online at prices from $1,000. Just go to the Own It Now page at buildingdetroit.org.
Always there when I needed. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from the William Clay Ford Athletic Center, right off the Lodge Freeway in Woodbridge. I'm with UAW Ford Vice President Jimmie Settles. Okay, we've gone through the other stuff. Tell me about this beautiful place. What does it actually have? I see two ball fields. What else?
Right here has two ball fields, but we also partnered. You can see the swing set over there. It wasn't us that did. We worked with the community to build that also. We have around the country, not only here in Detroit, built homes for veterans. We have built homes for blind people. We have built houses for veterans, not only in Michigan, you know, throughout the country. We firmly believe where we serve the community for which we work and live at. So, I know a lot is centered here, here in Michigan, but if you were to go to Kansas City with us, we can show you almost equal as much. If you go to Louisville, Kentucky, we can show you things that we're doing there. Mm-hmm. We go to Ohio. We have a permanent in six states. We build handicap ramps for those people that can't afford it throughout the country. And we've been doing that for the last 8 years. I'm kind of stumbling on, you know, all the things that we do. We feed the homeless. We talked about St. Peter, St. Paul. We also fed, over the last 6 years, 25,000 people during Christmas time. Really senior citizens throughout the country, and not only in Michigan, eight different states. Mm-hmm. I don't know, our people are, I can't even keep up because I can take credit for it, but the staff actually do it. Mm-hmm. And each one of our departments having at least one charity that they work for. Mm-hmm. We can talk about the abandoned kids, the teenage, unwed mothers, mm-hmm. you name it. They just go to it, so. Mm-hmm.
That's impressive. Is this field, before I get off into the harder questions, mm-hmm. is this field also used by adults or just children?
No, children. We made this for children because you look how many feet is this? 250 feet.
Pretend I know nothing about baseball.
This is for 16 and under. Uh-huh. We want this to be exclusively for kids. Mm-hmm. We didn't build this for adults. We built it for kids. Mm-hmm. And that's why the fencing that you see is the footage that it is, because that's regulation for a little league.
Thing I like best about this place is I finally got one up on my cameraman.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's from Macomb County. Whenever I go out, he says sometimes I have to meet him at the ball field because he's a baseball coach.
Uh-huh.
All right? And I look at the wonderful baseball fields they have out there and all that. I said, when we walked up, I said, how does this rank? How does this compare to what's out in Macomb County? He said, this is better. And when I heard that, I was like, oh, hell yeah.
That's good.
I mean, finally, we got something better.
And that's what the intent was, too. You see the lights. I used to coach also. And I remember we had a championship game in Kalamazoo. Mm-hmm. And we had a very good team. Our kids, first time they ever played under lights ever. And, we got beat really bad because, you know, they were really fascinated. They couldn't even watch the ball for watching the lights. Mm-hmm. And at that point, I knew, one day, through the grace of God, if I can do this, I'm going to build a park as equivalent to that, so I can kids be used to good things, can see good things. Mm-hmm. And I tell you, I come out here, I haven't been out much this year, but year before last, and it's really just a joy to see these kids come out here and play under the lights, you know, mm-hmm. like major leaguers, mm-hmm. you know, that's their dream. Some of them have dreams, but it's just a great sight to see.
Well, I think one of the things that the Major League Baseball is missing are African Americans.
Yes.
All right? You don't see them much anymore.
Right, that's true.
At all. Where are the Hank Aarons?
Yeah.
Okay, where are they?
Well, I think they're out here now. I mean, somewhere out there, there is one. Our kids don't get introduced to the game at an early age, and that's really the key. And that's the reason why we have these fields, so they can have not only a place, but a great place to play at, and a safe haven to play at.
Okay, when we come back, I've got to ask you, you detailed stuff nationwide that you're doing. You took it back home to here, to this beautiful park. I've got to ask you, how does UAW Ford do it?
Okay.
Okay, how is it actually done?
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for that?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, because you know I get hard. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Now, see more homes for sale than ever at buildingdetroit.org, including Own It Now homes, online at prices from $1,000. Just go to the Own It Now page at buildingdetroit.org.
No other restaurant in Detroit is getting more attention for their award-winning food and service than the Detroit Seafood Market. And not to be missed is their spectacular Sunday brunch. Omelets made to order, roast beef carvings, fried catfish, and wonderful homemade desserts. Just $30 for all you can eat and two complimentary champagne mimosas. There's also a bistro-style brunch served on Saturdays for $15. The Detroit Seafood Market, located in Paradise Valley.
Groundbreaking, life-saving, history-making. The new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from Woodbridge. We're coming to you from the William Clay Ford Athletic Center. These beautiful ball fields, which were built by the UAW Ford. My guest is Jimmie Settles, Vice President of UAW Ford. All right, buddy, in Mississippi, all right? In Mississippi, they blamed union misuse of funds using the FCA, the Fiat Chrysler mess that's going on now with the deceased General Vice President General Holyfield and my good friend Monica Morgan. They blamed that. They used social media, they did that. They said misuse of funds. Tell me, how was this built? Was this built off the back of dues paying union members?
The answer is no. We have a portion of our agreement that we set aside for joint programs. And it's up to the joint board, myself and the company, how we allocated those monies.
So this is a joint thing. It isn't just UAW, it's UAW Ford. So there are members from Ford and UAW that decide jointly how this is going to be done.
That's correct. That's correct. Yeah. And, you know, we got many, many different layers. Obviously, based on the amount of this field calls, all eight board members have to sign off on it. But what really happens in the beginning of the year, we develop a budget and put X amount of money aside for charities and special events. And, you know, then we carve it up from that point. So we try to do the bang for the buck. It's a negotiated item that's negotiated agreement that has nothing to do with union dues.
So Nissan was totally wrong.
I don't know what that, I'm not that close to it. I don't know what they said, but usually they are. So I can't.
Oh, they said some horrible things about you guys.
Yeah, well, I didn't get a chance to see that, but you know, I only can speak about what happened at Ford, UAW Ford. Mm-hmm. And I'm very, very proud about what we do around this country. And you talk to Ford Motor Company, they would say the same, mm-hmm. you know, that we do a lot for charity mm-hmm. Because that's the right thing to do. Mm-hmm. We've been blessed to make money and have a job. Mm-hmm. And part of it is to help those that need a helping hand. Mm-hmm. So we're very proud of that.
Well, you're definitely helping these kids. You're definitely helping at the homeless center, and you're definitely helping at DCP, yeah, at Northwestern, at your alma mater.
Yeah.
Okay, it needed it badly.
See, because I said, we not only did Northwestern, you go to Cass Tech, you go to Cody, you go to Osborne.
Every time I mention Cass, you call me bourgeois. You call me
bourgeois.
Well,
we went there first, you know, because we want to help the bourgeois out, you know.
See?
But no, seriously, I mean, all schools, they're so underfunded that they need help. I don't care what school you go to, you're not just a running joke with us. I mean, CAS is a very fine institution, very good leadership there. But we go all around the city helping a lot of schools. I probably can mention, especially the high schools, I don't think it's a high school in Detroit, not only public schools, we do Catholic schools, but as we speak right now, we just put over $750,000 in JZU.
Really?
Oh yeah. We helped them out there. They had an asbestos problem, and they wanted to enlarge the rooms. As we speak today, I was just over there day before yesterday. Loyola University, our boys' school. Mm-hmm. We helped their football team. We do inside the school. I mean, you just name it. I mean, probably it's easy for me to say the schools that we don't do than the schools that we do do.
That's amazing. Yeah. Well, look, I want to thank you for letting me come on your ball field. You know, I never thought I'd get to second base with you. Hello there. Anyway, by the way, I never thought I'd be standing on second base with you out here. But this is an amazing thing that you've done. It's even more amazing that you've done it in cooperation with the Ford Motor Company, hence the name UAW Ford, all right, and not off the backs of workers, as it was claimed in Mississippi.
Yeah.
All right. I love it. I want you to keep up the great work.
Thanks, Steve. Appreciate you.
All right, man. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, man.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, you've met the man we talked about 2 weeks ago. It can be done. It's part of those public-private partnerships. You've also heard him dispel the myth of that madness in Mississippi. Our unions are part of the strongest part of the fiber of our society, our American society. Why do we have a five-day work week? The unions. Why do we have sick days? The unions. Why did maternity leave even start? The unions. Who stops unfair labor practices by bosses? The unions. That's it. Yes, the Snyder administration has attacked them, trying to make Michigan a total right-to-work state. But the unions are what have given us the quality of life that we have today, that we know and love. The things that we take for granted brought to us by the unions. We'll be back next week.